heterozygous dominant. So, as I have stated in the definition, the F1 generation offspring should be tall or dominant. Is it dominant or not? The F1 generation is dominant or not? It is dominant, right? That is the law of dominant. Or some people may tell in this way also. There is one more definition for law of dominance. In all the cross which have two alleles. Have two alleles in any clause. One of the allele will dominate the other one and it express. One allele will dominate the other allele and that will be expressed in the phenotypic and genotypic characters. Okay. In the phenotypic character, if the dominant trait is expressing, so it is suppressing the other character, the recessive character. So we can say in this way also. In a cross, we have two alleles. The one allele will dominate the other allele. The dominant allele will express and the recessive allele will suppress. Okay, in this way also we can explain the law of dominance. Now you are clear the law of dominance? Everyone are clear? Do you have any confusions? Okay, so this is law of dominance. And law of dominance can be explained with both monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross. Can be explained both in the monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross. Okay, next law is law of segregation. Or Mendel's second law. This is Mendel's second law. Law of segregation or Mendel's second law. What do you mean? Again, we will explain this with the help of a cross only. Okay, parents. Okay, we can take any kind of parents here. Or we start with pure lines only. Okay, the same cross. Again, we'll explain here gametes. Here we have two alleles. Each allele has like its own purity. Either this thing can express or this thing can express. Both will have purity of gametes. This law of segregation is called also called as purity of gametes. It will determine the purity of gametes. Each allele will have its independence or it will not mix up with the other allele. It will independently segregate. Okay, here it is, it can go and cross with this thing. The same thing can go and cross with this thing. This thing also can cross with this. And this also can cross with this. So though they are similar, they are not mixing up. They are segregating separately. They are separate. They are segregating, right? They are not mixing up altogether. Both alleles will not mix up. They will segregate independently. That is law of segregation. So it will determine the purity of gametes. What does the law of segregation determine? It will determine the purity of gametes. The purity of gametes. Clear? The alleles will not mix together. They have their character which will separate or which will not mix with any other trait, any other allele. Okay. This will not go and mix with this. Either this will not go and mix with this. Even if you have heterozygous parents, both will have its independence. They will separate and form different alleles and different gametes which will combine to give new character. A new phenotype, right? They will separately segregate and they will cross with different parents and they will form different gametes and zygote in the last. Zygote is nothing but which we get phenotype or genotype. Okay, two gametes will combine to form a zygote, right? That is what we get, genotype or phenotype. So they will have their independence, they will segregate, they will not mix up with each other. That is law of segregation. What does that determine? Purity of gametes. Okay. Next we have third law. That is law of independent assortment. cannot be explained using monohybrid cross. It can be explained only with the help of dihybrid cross. Okay, it should have two different characters. It can be explained only using dihybrid cross. Whereas first law and second law can be explained both by using monohybrid cross and dihybrid cross. That is why I have mentioned it can before first law and second law that can be explained using monohybrid and dihybrid. Law of independent assortment can be explained only using dihybrid cross. There we have taken only one character, height. Here we will take two characters. Okay, any two characters can be taken and it has to be crossed. So two hybrids are there. We are crossing the two hybrids. Then that is why it is called as dihybrid cross. We need to only one character. Here we will be taking two characters. Okay. Suppose can you tell me any two characters in the field type?
C.
Brown and yellow. Okay. We need to take these two characters. Always that will start with pure lines. So brown, yellow is crossed with. Bring it green. Here is parents. This is brown, yellow, and this is bring it green. In the earlier cross, we have seen only one character, that is height. But here we are seeing two different characters. That is why we had called that as monohybrid. That is why we are calling here, we have two characters, that is why we call it dihybrid cross. Here with the terminology names. Okay, now see here. Independent assortment means, so now we have two R's and two Y here. Now when we take gametes, like, let me explain here only. Yeah, we have this R. This can go and cross, this two can combine, this R and this Y can combine. The same R can combine with this. Otherwise, this two can combine and this can combine. So, the name states law of independent assortment. Like each have their own independence. Okay, they will assort independently. They are not depending on each other. Anything can go and cross with any other allele. So, we have two R's. Common, we can just get one R and cross with all the others. But it is not like that in the case when you do it practically. When you just write the theoretical form, we can do it. But practically, it doesn't happen. When we have four separate alleles, we will get four different gametes also. We get four different gametes also. Here, all might be similar. Okay. This R born by this way. This R born by this way. Okay, four different gametes, and the same here also we'll get four different gametes. So they are assorting independently, independent of each other. Each allele is not depending on the other allele. Okay, next let us see in detail more. Now we have got the gametes from this side, RY. From here, okay, let us cross this. The first generation we will get capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. But what is the phenotype here? Brown and yellow only. Can the law of dominance be explained here? Can the law of dominance be explained? Law of segregation can be explained. What I told you in dominance? Always the F1 generation, when you start across pure line, F1 generation parents, F1 generation offspring will be dominant. Brown yellow is dominant. Brown yellow is dominant, right? So, law of dominance and segregation can be explained in dihybrid cross also. Okay, now we are talking about law of independent assortment. Now, we will do self cross here. This is F1 generation offspring and we will self cross it. What do you mean by self cross? When we cross the offspring with the same, when we do it across basic same 16 different phenotypes, right, or 16 different offsprings. If we do it cross with the same generation offspring, we are crossing with the same generation offspring, okay, then it is called as selfing. Okay, now we are crossing with the same generation offspring. Okay, this is called as self cross or selfing. Okay, when we do the selfing, we will get 16 different phenotypes. 16 offsprings we will get. How do we get 16 offsprings? Here again I am using this. Yeah. See, it is having. Stop talking. Again, here law of segregation can be explained. They are not mixing with each other. They are not mixing with each other. We get four different gametes. Stop talking. After the class, I'll ask you to do the cross. I do different cross and I'll ask you to do. Please concentrate. Okay, here also you'll get same. So, can you see anywhere that depending on each other, any allele is depending on any other allele? Here we have four alleles. Are they depending on each other? No, they are independently assorted and they are giving different phenotypes also, different genotypes also. So, this is law of independent assortment. This is law of independent assortment. Clear, right? What is law of independent assortment? Okay. So, these are the three laws of Mendel. Law of dominance, law of segregation and law of independent assortment. Their alleles in segregation, the alleles are not mixing up with each other. Here, all the gametes or all the alleles have individuality or independence to assort. Okay. Clear? Don't get confused with second law and third law. Okay. Now, let's start with monohybrid cross. Pure line pairings. answer you should mention is the parent. Here you have to mention is the parent. Okay, next, gamete. You have certain rules when you do a cross also. You should mention these are also important. Parent and gamete. And gamete should always be inside a circuit. Okay, and okay. Please don't talk. Anirudh, take. Don't talk. Okay, now I have got the parents. I have got the gametes. And next, I'll do the cross. I'll get F1 generation of brains. I can do it in the bullet. Anirudh, please come and sit here. Okay, F1 generation. I will do it in the Punnett square. And here, anyway, you can mention it as male and female. If you mention male, you should write the male gametes here. If you mention female here, should be the female characters there. Okay, you can do it in any way. So you can write female here, male here also. But it is just indication of a cross. Male and female will be there in a cross, right? But showing that indication, we just mentioned male and female. I already told you in the last class, will you note this for male, this symbol, female will be denoted with this symbol. Clear? Okay, now, capital W. Small W, capital W, small W. Okay, now we got F1 generation. We have got all the heterozygous dominant. Now, once you do the F1 generation, you have to mention the phenotypic ratio and genotypic ratio also. What is phenotypic ratio? That can be seen. Anything that can be seen, whether the color or the shape or the height, all these are phenotypic characters. Genotype means the genetic composition of one allele. See, W, capital W and small W, that is genotypic. Genotype.
Can the female
thing
be put down?
Yeah, it can be put in any way. So we are just denoting, we have male gametes and female gametes. Okay, now what is phenotype? I am telling this is purple color flower. When I take purple color, then it is phenotype. When I take capital W, small W, that is genotype. Genotype is genetic composition of a allele or a character. Phenotype is that it can be seen. Okay. Okay, now I write the phenotypic ratio. Phenotypic ratio as, what is the phenotypic ratio? 4:0. And genotypic ratio is also same. Now, I'll do the self cross. I'll do the self cross. Self cross can be done or if I ask. Yeah, I'll show you the two things. Now, self cross is, we got capital W, small W in the F1 generation. That is heterozygous dominant. Okay. If I cross the same, then it is selfing. Now, gametes. Again, you have to mention parents. P2, just mention P2, G2. And now you will mention as F2 generation. We have got F1 generation. Now we are doing it for F2 generation. So we have done the self cross here. Clear? You are following me? Okay. Now, please tell it in the terms of ratio only. And as percentage, we can tell in 75%, 25%. Okay. Now, what is the phenotypic ratio? How many tall individuals are there?
Three.
And how many tall?
Purple and white.
One. Yeah, purple and white. This is purple and this is white. But the ratio is 3:1. Clear? This is the phenotypic ratio. Now, let it take genotypic ratio. What is the ratio of genotypic ratio?
1:2.
Yeah, 1:2:1. So, 1 is completely dominant. Homozygous dominant. These two are heterozygous dominant. The other one is homozygous recessive. So, 1:2:1. Clear with the genotypic ratio? Clear the genotypic ratio? 1:2:1 is the genotypic ratio. Whereas phenotypic ratio is 3:1. Why 3:1? 3 are dominant, that is purple, and 1 is white. 3:1. Purple and white. Phenotypic ratio, 1 is capital W, which is again purple color. Other 2 is capital W, which again codes for purple only. But it is heterozygous dominant, that is why we have mentioned it separately. It has separate genetic composition. When we compare to this, it has different composition, right? It is different, right? When we compare with this. So, separately we will write. And this is recessive. So, 1:2:1. That is, always when they ask, when they start with pure line, when you write some competitive exams, they will just mention, with a pure line cross, in a monohybrid cross, what is the ratio of, what is the genotypic ratio in F2 generation? 1:2:1. Phenotypic ratio 3:1. These are same for all the crosses. So you can just remember this. You need not do all the graphs when they ask in competitive exam. It is like waste of your time. So just remember this ratio, which is constant for all the crosses. All the monohybrid crosses, the parents are pure line. The F2 generation is the ratio is 3:1 and 1:2:1. So you have to remember these things. Okay, now in monohybrid cross only, we have two different types of crosses, test cross and bad cross. What is test cross? You studied in your school?
No.
Okay, let us see here. What is test cross? What is bad cross? This is monohybrid cross only. There are different types of monohybrid cross.
Test cross and
bad cross. One is test cross. Other is bad cross. Okay, what is test cross? You will do a cross, you will get F1 generation offspring. That F1 generation offspring, if you are crossing with any recessive parent, if you are crossing with any recessive parent, then that is test cross. You should cross with only the recessive parent. You will not do with the dominant parent, only with the recessive. That is test cross. The F1 is crossed with recessive parent. Okay. Now what is bad cross? Here also same thing. F1 generation offspring is crossed with either of the parents. Any of the parents. Parents might be anything. Maybe dominant, maybe recessive, maybe heterozygous, maybe homozygous, anything. If you are crossing with any of the parent, then it is bad cross. If I go through the examples, you will understand it better. F1 generation offspring into any or B. Either of the parent. Either of the parents. It doesn't matter if it is dominant, if it is recessive, homozygous, heterozygous. If you are crossing F1 generation with any parent, then that is bad cross. If you are crossing F1 generation with recessive parent, that is test cross. Again, the ratios of phenotypic ratio and genotypic ratio of these are also same in all the crosses. You will see now. Can you tell me one example?
Okay.
Test the cross. Test the cross? Example.